இப்போ உங்க லெஃப்ட் ஹேண்ட் சைடுல நேம் இருக்கு, என்ன நேம் பாருங்க மேடம். கீழே அந்த அன்மியூட்டுக்கு மேலே பாருங்க, கீழே இருக்கு நேம். மியூட் பார்த்ததெல்லாம் நேம், உங்க நேம் அதுல என்ன அந்த பார்ட்டிசிபென்ட் இருக்குல்ல மேடம், ஷேர் ஸ்க்ரீனு பக்கத்தில் பார்ட்டிசிபென்ட் இருக்குல்ல, அந்த பார்ட்டிசிபென்ட் கிளிக் கிளிக் பண்ணுங்க. அதில் உங்களுக்கு ஃபஸ்ட்டு நேம், உங்கள் நேம் என்ன இருக்கு, என்ன என்ன நேம் இருக்கு, பர்சனல் இருக்குங்களா? ஓகே 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 மேடம், நான் அது அன்மியூட் பண்ணிடுறேன். ஓகே
I don't see her here. It's not coming.
No, it's not.
Good morning, Maithili ma'am. Maithili ma'am, good morning. Maithili ma'am. She's not come. Maithili ma'am, good morning.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, now I can.
Yes, okay.
Ma'am, can you pull down the camera bit?
Jitesh is saying something. Jitesh?
Yes, ma'am. The camera has to be brought a bit lower.
Maithili ma'am?
Yes, yes.
Maithili ma'am?
Yes?
Kindly bring the camera closer. Lower.
Lower. Yeah, that's fine.
Are able to see me?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, now it's fine.
It's okay?
Yeah, okay. It's okay, ma'am.
It's focusing somewhere. It's not focusing me. Now it is okay?
Yeah, it's okay, ma'am.
Okay. Should I unmute? Should I mute myself?
No, remain as you are now. We can okay. Hear you.
Yeah. Okay.
Ajay, I'll start panikla.
Okay. Namaste. Decades have passed by, but human suffering has remained constant through the ages. Today we are here to enlighten ourselves on the power of music and its instantaneous effect on one's mind. A warm welcome to all our viewers to the auspicious music therapy webinar on Raga as Diet and its therapeutic benefits, featured by four speakers who are scholars in music, in therapy, and in Raga Chikitsa. A warm welcome to all our speakers. We have today as our speakers Dr. T. Maithili, Dr. Aishat M., Isai Kalar Valarmani, Sri R. Ganesh Raman, and Guru Srimati Priya Iyer. A warm welcome to all of you with our felicitations. We welcome our first speaker, Dr. Aishat M., MD in Ayurveda, Kaumara Bhritya, in other words, pediatrician, currently working as assistant professor in Government Ayurveda College, Tripunithura, Ernakulam, Kerala. Dr. Aishat has had training in Hindustani music under the tutelage of Srimati Abaradita Banerjee. For her studies in music therapy, she was guided and assisted by Dr. M. V. Anil Kumar, head of the department, Government Ayurveda College, Trivandrum, and Sri Ajit Nambudiri, Carnatic musician, Trivandrum. She has treated autism with music therapy on Hindustani flute with Vidwan Sri Himanshu Nanda performing. A warm welcome to Dr. Aishat. Dr. Aishat.
Okay, can you see me?
You can start, yes. Thank you.
In the name of Almighty God, a very good morning to all. And I'm very happy to stand in the virtual platform of Ayurveda Pharmacy to speak on the topic music therapy. Actually, I have very few experiences in this topic, but I want to share, I'll be sharing with you the scientific aspect of music therapy. Rather, how can we use the music therapy judiciously for the treatment of various diseases, and what is the scientific aspect, and how Ayurveda look into the aspect of music therapy. Before going to the presentation, I thank all the organizers of Ayurveda Pharmacy for giving me a chance to speak on this topic. And I thank the most respected Sri Krishna Humaji sir and all the pioneers of AVP institution and all the respected audience of this webinar, the members of Kalakshetra, all the other speakers. A very good morning to all, and I will just share my screen and go into my presentation.
Sure.
I think you can see my slide. Is it clear?
Yes.
You can hear me, no?
Yeah, it's clear.
Okay. So here, now the topic is Raga as Diet. This is very important, as the title itself denotes. It is termed Raga as Diet, and not only Raga, its therapeutic benefits. In this present situation, this is very important. We know the importance of balanced diet, especially in this COVID time. The importance of balanced diet has been propagated by all of the health professionals regarding how to improve our immunity, regarding the prevention of lifestyle diseases, how to prevent the contagious diseases, and all we are being propagated about the importance of balanced diet. But how many of us are aware of the diet that is important for our mind and soul, or the diet which is very important for the existence of the sattva and atma, which is called as tridanda in Ayurveda? That is, not only the sharira, the sattva and atma is also very important for the existence of your life. Now, Ayurveda describes the health of an individual as not only the health of a body. It is clearly mentioned, sama doshaha, sama agnishya, sama dhadu malakriyaha, prasanna atma indriyaha, swastha iti abhidiyede. It is not only the health of the body. You have to have a prasanna atma, indriya, and mana to have a swastha life. This is what Ayurveda propagates. And for this, Ayurveda describes sattva avajaya chikitsa. Sattva means mind, and it is having two doshas, that is rajas and tamas. And the guna which we have to have is the sattva guna, which is should predominate the rajas and tamas of the mind. And the chigilsa which aims for reducing the rajas and tamas is called sattva avajaya chigilsa. And according to the predominance of these particular characters, that is sattva, rajas and tamas, we divide the sattva into three types, that is satyuga, rajasa and tamasa. And satyuga types of mental temperament persons will be having, these sorts of temperaments, that is chauja, astikya, dharma, madhi, And the Rajasa will be having more of Mana, Krodha, Damba, Malsara. And this Mana means egoism. Krodha is, you know, anger. Damba means, again, unhealthy proudness. And Malsara is unhealthy competition. And Tamasa people will be having more of Bhaya, Ajnana, Nidralasya, and Vishada. That is nothing but fear, ignorance, you know, sleepy attitude, and Vishada. That means depression. You can see the three gunas of mind, that is sattva, rajas and tamas. These are all present in us. That is all, actually these all gunas are needed for our body, for the real functioning of the individual. That sattva is needed for balance, harmony, positivity, peace, clarity, creativity, openness and intelligence. Rajas is needed for movement, activity, you know, excitement, etc. But if it is increases, it will lead to agitation, anxiety and egotism. Tamas is also needed for our body for inactivity. We need rest, isn't it? So it is needed for us. But if it is increases, it will lead to dullness, depression and ignorance. According to the types of treatment, it is called as, it is divided into Yukti Vyapashraya and Sattva Avajaya. So we can include the behavioral therapies, counseling, and music therapy and all in the Satta Avajaya Chigilsa. The importance of mind in causation of diseases. This is very important. In Ayurveda, there are two adhishtana for diseases, that is the both Kaya and Mana. And the increase of rajas and tamas in the body leads to all sorts of diseases. Therefore, Ayurveda prescribes Sadvritta and that is moral conduct, and Dharaniya Vegas, that is the Vegas we should we should avoid, like anger, fear, etc. should be avoided for the increase of sattva guna of mind, and that lead to the immunity of the body. Not only immunity is not only considered about the immunity of body, it is also depend upon the immunity of the sattva that you have. And that is why Ayurveda describes the importance of prajnabharata in the causation of diseases. That is, when the rajas and tamoguna increases, it will lead to the prajnabharata and leads to sarva dosha prakoba in the body and lead to all sorts of diseases. Here you can see a water jar which is filled with water. Whatever, when we heat the tumbler, the water gets heated up. So likewise, any disease which is affecting the body also affects the mind, and any disease which is affecting the mind, it affects the body also. So this is basic of psychiatric illness or psychosomatic diseases and somatoform disorders that we see today. Here also it is the Dharaniya Vegas are there. That is, we have to control our emotions like Lobha, Isha, Dvesha, Malsarya, etc. And we have to follow Sadvritta, that is moral conduct, for increasing the Sattva Guna of the mind and reducing the Rajas and Tamo Bhavas of mind. So music intervention is a type of Sattva Chigilsa, where we use music for increase of sattva guna and decrease the rajas and tamo bhavas of mind. The importance of music intervention is that it doesn't need much effort and time from the part of the subject. Therefore, it is more relevant in the present era in terms of application. The background of music therapy or experience of music therapy of mind begins that I conducted during my PG studies, and it is the study on the combined effect of specific music intervention and Kalyana Grida in childhood autism. And this study, I have been guided by Dr. M.V. Anil Kumar. He is now presently working as HOD at Department of Kaumarabhatya, Government Ayurveda College, Thiruvananthapuram. And why we selected autism is because in autism, we saw that in 80% of autistic individuals are having some sort of inclination towards music. So music perception and music making is known to be a relative strength of individuals with autism. And we had 24 patients, and in half of the patients we gave Hindustani flute, and in half of the patients we gave, along with Hindustani flute, we gave what, medicine also. And this flute music was recorded by Sri Himanshu Nanda. He is the disciple of Pandit Hariprakal Chaudhasya, and he has been recommended by Sri Ajit Nambudiri. He is a famous Carnatic musician from Kerala. These are my three guides, that is Sri Himanshu Nanda, Sri Ajit Nambudiri, and Sri Ambi Anil Kumar. And the ragas that we used for this particular study was six ragas, that is Yaman, Bhagyashri, Pahari, Chandra Counts, Bhupali, and Meg. And these are all statistical studies of statistical analysis of the study, and I'm just skipping all these things. And I will show the final result of the study. The trial intervention produced a very significant improvement in the domain listening response and relating to people, body use, verbal communication, and general expression of the autistic individuals. The conclusion of my study was music can do a lot in autism, especially in communication, sensory integration, comprehension, creative expression, and social interaction. And in combination with Ayurvedic medicines, we can do wonders with autism, because it is not only an art, it is a science too. There are many studies which are being done with music therapy in both nationally and internationally. And these are some papers that I would like to share with you. That is, this is the effect of music therapy in reducing invasive procedural pain. And this is one study, that is music therapy, which increases breastfeeding rates among mothers of premature newborns. Effects of a sound bed intervention on patients diagnosed with cancer, etc. These are only a few studies that I shared with you. And it is seen that in NICU, that is provided with music intervention, the babies had increased cognitive development, increased language development, and increased parent-child bonding, and increased parental education and support in the child, which is provided, which is subjected to music intervention at NICU. And this is the most familiar thing that we see today, that is in cattle sheds and all. The cattle are exposed to music, and it led to increased milk production in the cattle. Various studies have been conducted in plant growth also. This is one study which is conducted at Colorado. And in this particular study, the plants are exposed to different types of music. That is, you can see that the third plant, which is exposed to the Indian classical music, showed much growth compared to the other two, which is exposed to the rock music, which is fast music. So this is very important, because the type of music that we use is also important in the field of music therapy. So it is not only an art, it is a science too. These are the neurologic music therapy techniques and definitions that are being used today. Like, there are various terms that is being used instead of music therapy. All these things use some forms of sound for the music intervention. These are, for example, rhythmic auditory stimulation, pattern sensory enhancement, melodic intonation therapy, rhythmic speech cueing, vocal intonation therapy, etc., etc. All this use some sort of sound for the stimulation of brain and mind. Actually, music is a sound generating particular vibrations which moves through the medium of ether or akasha present in the atmosphere and affecting the human body. When we look into how brain processes music, we know that music is composed of various elements like pitch, timbre, key, harmony, loudness, rhythm, meter, etc. So when we hear a particular music, the brain has to have, or brain has to be stimulated in various parts. Almost all parts of brain have to work to process all these elements. So when we hear music, we can stimulate the brain, and we can have different changes in the brain. And we can see that the auditory nerve that through which the auditory signals is passed to the brain is having more connections in the brain compared to the other cranial nerves. Then this is one also studies shows that it is having effect on various biochemical messengers like hormones, neurotransmitters, etc. When we hear to music. This is one important study which is conducted by Abhishek Gangre, and he used, you know, different types of music, like, you know, music of Johann Strauss, Ravi Shankar, and Mozart, and he saw that different types of music created different effect in the body. Like one music increased adrenaline, and in another decreased adrenaline. So this here is where, you know, we have to have a guideline as to how to use music as to cure diseases, because it is not that we can use all music for music therapy, because in whatever manner good, you know, good music is doing good to body, in that manner bad music good bad to the body, that is it will increase the rajas and tamas of the body and leads to diseases. So in this particular context, how can we use music judiciously for treatment? Here is where we have Hida and we have Lavanya. Hida means our, it is good to the body, but Lavanya means we like different foods. We like, for example, we like pizza, we like burger, etc. But it is not good for our body. But Hida means which is Hida to our body. So likewise, we have to have Hida music too. So here is where Indian system has given a guideline as to which, how to use music therapy. Broadly speaking, we can divide music therapy according to Indian system into three. That is, first one is mantra based, second one is nada based, and third one is raga based. And here the topic is raga based, but I will be shortly giving you a few as to how mantra based and nada based is discussed in Ayurveda. The raga based is the latest evolved thing. It is not described well in Ayurveda, but it is a practical way of doing music therapy nowadays. But actually, mantra based and nada based are the music therapies which are more described in Ayurvedic texts and the Hatha Yoga, etc. We can see that the origin of music comes from the Vedas, and the foundations of the music is in Samaveda. In mantra therapy, we use different mantras. For example, in Kaumara Pratyas, for example, in pediatrics, we have different mantras during every stage of development of a child, starting from conception, during the pregnancy, after, during delivery, and during development of the child. The Ayurvedic text describes various mantras to be recited over the child's ear, to be recited over the pregnant lady, to be recited during delivery process, to ease delivery, etc. So why these mantras are used? This is actually the primary aim is to become closer to our creator. That is really understood. But the second thing is that this act as also a sound therapy, which will stimulate our brain and which will calm our mind. And this is called mantra chigilsa, and this is very well described in Ayurvedic text. Various mantras have been mentioned in Ayurveda. How can we use this practically? We know we have holy religious text of ourselves, like we have Quran, Bhagavad Gita, Bible, and this all religious text we read in a particular tune, isn't it? We don't read in as we read a text. We read in particular tune. Why? Because a tune, when we read it in a particular tune, that will stimulate our mind and that will lead to calmness of our mind. So apart from being, you know, praying to God, and second thing, it can act as a mantra therapy which can calm your mind. And second one is the nada based. Nada means sound itself, and the importance of sound is very well described in Ayurveda. Sound means we have Pancha Mahabhudas. And among the Pancha Mahabhuda, Akasha Mahabhuda is the finest and subtlest of all Mahabhudas. And sound or nada is the quality of Akasha Mahabhuda. So it can deeply penetrate into the body, because it doesn't need any, you know, matter to go into the body. So it can pass into the body deeply and affect each cell of our body. You know, each cell is having its movement. Our body is having a rhythm. This nature is also having a rhythm. Rhythm means what? Rhythm is nothing but music. So wherever there is a movement, there is blood circulation, there is movement of protons, neutrons, everything. Wherever there is movement, a particular sound is there. But actually it is inaudible to us, that is another case. But whether it is audible or inaudible, there is a lot of movements occurring in our cells. So whenever the movement is there, the sound is produced. So this rhythm is very well required for the natural and the healthy existence of the individual. When this rhythm is disrupted, what happened? This lead to various type of diseases. When we listen to a particular, particular rhythmic movement or rhythmic music, which is like mantra or like raga, etc., these cells will, retain their rhythm and can lead to harmony of the body. In Nada Yoga is very well explained in Hatha Yoga. This text describes Nada Yoga very well. That is, it is Indriyana Manonadaha, Manonadastu Marudaha, Marudasya Layo Nadaha, Salayo Nada Mashridaha. That is, the explanation is the Nada means the ruler or the one who rules is called Nada. So Indriyana, Indriya means senses. The ruler of our manas is Indriya, the senses. Manonadastu Marudaha, the one who rules the manas is Maruda or Vada, especially Pranavayu. And Marudasya Layo Nadaha, the ruler of the Maruda is Laya or dissolution. And Sa Layo Nada Mashridaha, that Laya is dependent on the sound. The sound is the inner sound of our body. And this particular Nada Yoga can be achieved only by yogic persons actually. That is, we have to hear the inner sound of our body, and when we attain this particular state, it is a particular state of samadhi. So this is actually impossible for the normal persons like us. So in this case, the third is very effective. That is, raga based is a practical sense. Raga based music therapy is having utility in this particular era. And we can see that the chakras are different. Chakras are the 7 chakras are there in our body. These are nothing but energy points in our spinal cord, which is connected to various organs and organ systems of our body. And these chakras are having a sound basis. Each chakra is having a sound basis or mantra, and this mantra is said to stimulate the chakra and coordinate the movements of the activities of the organs that is being connected to. The third and the most important thing, that is raga-based music therapy. This is the most evolved thing that is apart from the mantra-based and nada-based. This is important because in the practical approach, we can use this particular thing for the therapies. Raga means nothing but to please or which is agreeable. So different ragas are melodic framework, which is intended to induce certain emotions in the listener. And we all know that there are 2 types of music in Indian system, that is Carnatic and Hindustani. And the main difference with Western classical music is that Indian ragas are not composed by a composer. It is created through a lengthy evolutionary process over centuries. Thus, they do not represent mind of the composer, but a universal idea of the world. That is the importance of Indian system, because these ragas, this contain different ragas have different arrangement of swaras. So each raga is having different pitch, different tone, different articulation, and this particular thing we can use to stimulate different emotions in the body, leading to the treatment of different diseases. And especially in Hindustani classical raga, we can see that there is specific time for singing for a particular raga. This particular thing we can use in the treatment, because in Ayurveda also it is our doshas, we have our bodily doshas. This is being changed from the morning to evening according to the time. So this particular thing we can use, for example, the morning time, that is from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. it is a kapha time. So the people which is having kapha type disorders, or the body, the person who is having a kapha constitution, so he can use a particular raga which is said to, or which is having the time in that morning. For example, Rag Bhairav is a morning raga. So this can be treated, used for treating the kapha disorders. Likewise, the Rag Bilawal can be used to treat pitta disorders, and Rag Marwa in vada disorders. So I'm not well versed with the different ragas to treat different diseases. I know there are many experts in this webinar to discuss the practical approach as to different how to use different ragas in different treatment. And these are some ragas which is used in different diseases, like Ashavari, Bhagyashri, Bhairavi, Taffy, Marwa, etc. in different disorders. These are some taggers that I used for my study. That's Yam and Rag, Rag Bhairav, and Rag Bhageshi, etc. These are flute music that I've recorded and I've make use of in autism. Rag Pilu is used in depression, anxiety, and in absent-mindedness, and Rag Kafi can be used in sleep disorders. We can see that whenever we hear to a music, it is having a pranayama effect, isn't it? When we are doing a pranayama, what we are doing is we are controlling our pranavayu. Pranavayu is the vayu which is controlling the functions of our manas or our mental activities. That is said in Ayurveda. That is pranas tandra yendra daraha niyanda pranada cha manasaha. So when we listen to a music also, we are actually, when we keen listening to it, what is happening is we are controlling our pranavayu, we are controlling our vata, and thereby we are controlling the mental activities also. So we can, it is a sort of pranayama, but not up to that level. But you know, pranayama is needed. To do pranayama, one has to be very, to take effort. But in children below 5 years and all, they can't do pranayama. So in this state, we can use certain types of music, can be made to listen, and it can have a result similar to pranayama. And being the amurta dosha, that means vada is amurta, we can see vada. So it responds to the amurta bhavas, that is, it's invisible bhavas or stimuli which permeates with and without the voluntary activity of the individual. The vibrations of musical sounds pacify vada and pitta. In Ayurveda, it is mentioned that, it specifically mentioned that hearing to music reduces pitta also in the body, not only vada but also pitta. So mainly listening to music reduces vada and pitta of a body. Direct reference of music therapy is mentioned in pitta treatment, and that is hearing of vocal or instrumental music which is agreeable, mild, sweet and pleasant to the mind reduces the pitta. So how Ayurveda and music is related? You know, importance of shabda is told in Ayurveda. Then shlokas, Ayurveda itself is shlokas. Ayurveda, most of the Ayurvedic texts are full of shlokas, not in gadya form, it is in padya form. Why? Because when we study in the form of shlokas, our brain catches it very easily. So from that itself, we can understand that our brain is having some inclination to the music, isn't it? So that is the you know, interaction between us and the music. Then mantras are described in Ayurveda. In Pitta Chikitsa, Hari Gidam is mentioned. And in Hatha Yoga text, a principle called Nada Yoga is mentioned. And we have Shad Chakras, which is having sound basis. All this indicates the importance of music with our body. And the possible areas of intervention include, you know, as I already told, not only psychiatric disorders, but also psychosomatic disorders like bronchial asthma. All these are having some sort of, you know, cause in the mind also, not only in the body, but also mind. And like disorders like fibromyalgia, rheumatoid arthritis, and allergic disorders. Possible actions may be effect on Shad Chakras. It can have Nada Yoga effect, Pranayama effect, Shabda Tanmatra affecting Sushma Bhavas of mind and brain, decreasing Rajas and Tamas, and increasing Sattva Bhava of mind, reducing Sharira Doshas, especially Vada and Pitta, and underlying neural mechanisms and plastic changes in brain. All this are want to be found out by future research. So this is what I wanted to share with you. And we know that in this present, especially in COVID time, we are hearing a lot of suicides, isn't it? We recently heard about the suicide of a famous Bollywood actor. So what is the problem with him? You know, he's having all sort of luxurious life, but he's committing suicide. So this is because he's not able to control his mindly faculties, isn't it? He's not able to have control over his sattva, and he's committing suicide. So why this happens is because he is having more rajas and tamo bhavas in the mind, and he is not having sattva guna for this particular thing. That is, for increasing sattva guna and to reduce rajas and tamas, we have to have measures that we can do. In that comes the music therapy. It is not that only music therapy is there for increasing sattva guna. It is only one of the methods by which we can increase sattva guna, that too with right music, not with all sort of music. You know, different types of music are there now, like rock music, all sorts of you know, music is there. All this music actually sometimes can increase rajas and tamas. So this is where we have to have right choice of music, which we can use to increase the sattva guna of mind and thereby decrease rajas and tamas and lead a fruitful life. So with this, I'm ending my session, and I would like to sing one song, which is based on only a four lines, which is based on a rock kafi, and it is a famous Hindi song. So please forgive my mistakes. And this kafi song, raga, is can be used in sleep disorders to induce sleep, and whoever who's having not sleep, disturbed sleep and all, they can use raga kafi. That is very helpful, and I will sing four lines from a famous song.
जलते हैं जिसके लिए तेरे आँखों के दिए ढूंढ लाया वही गीत में तेरे लिए जलते हैं जिसके लिए तेरे आँखों के दिए ढूंढना वही गीत में तेरे लिए जलते हैं जिसके लिए जब तलक ना ये तेरे रस्ते भर होठों से मिले यूं ही आवारा फिरेगा ये तेरे जुल्फों की तले जब तलक ना ये तेरे रस के भरे होठों से मिले यूं ही आवारा फिरेगा ये तेरे जुल्फों की तले गाए जाऊंगा ये गीत में तेरे लिए जलते हैं जिसके
So thank you for a patient listening, and once again I thank all the organizers of the program for inviting me to speak on the topic. So thank you once again.
Thank you, Dr. Aishat. We welcome our next speaker, Dr. T. Maithili, a cognitive neuropsychologist and a music therapist of Chennai. She is a private practitioner with two doctoral degrees, one in psychology and the other in music therapy in medical field. Dr. Maithili is a recipient of innumerable prestigious awards, titles and laurels in the field of science and music. Also, she is a performing classical vocalist and a fortunate disciple of revered Padma Vibhushan Dr. M. Balamurali Krishna. Taking all the blessings of all her gurus, guides and tutors who have played a vital role in the making of Dr. T. Maithili, a very successful and an accomplished personality, we welcome ma'am for her speech. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes, Dr. Maithili. Can start.
Yes.
I could
not able to see you. Hello.
Yeah, we can. Yes, madam. You can start.
Thank you very much for the AVP Pharmacy to inviting me to speak in this occasion. Are you seeing me? Hello.
Yes, ma'am, you're audible and you're visible.
I'm visible, okay. So in this opportunity, everybody speaks
your
about...
Your video is off now.
My video is off, is it? It is good? Are you getting
yes.
it?
Yes.
music therapy, if we say it is a diet, we know diet for the palate, spicy food, sweet, like that. All the shadrasas may be available. But when we are speaking about the diet for the ears, you should listen selectively. We cannot go on listening too many things. That time, we may likely to get disturbed, or sometimes we get annoyed. We bet sometimes we go for the noisy areas, there we come back with simple headache. So that way, diet differs for each senses. All the five senses differ with that. You take spicy food for the palate, then you can listen soft music or whatever it is, soothing words, comfortable words. That also comes under the diet. So you cannot go for the harsh words, the rising volumes may likely to, that's why you used to say volume reduce, but you to say like that. So that way, diet for the eyes, you can go for the sceneries, superb, excellently giving natural views like that. So when you are listening to the ears, that is, it should be natural. Then for the nostrils, you can go for the fragrance, that is pleasant smells. That way, when we are listening music, it is a direct experience before being transformed into thought and feelings. For simple example, if you are eating some spicy food, what will happen? We immediately feel the spicy taste, that it has to be get digested to have the effect on our body. So whereas it is for the eatables, but when we are listening music, it is a direct experience. Now we listen. Ga 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 ri 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 sa 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 ni pa ga ri ga pa ni pa ga ri ga ri sa ni pa ga pa ni ni pa ga pa ni sa. What is that I did now? Just a simply a small phrase of few notes. Ga 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 ri 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 sa sa ni pa ga ri. The moment we started hearing it, that it has a direct experience. We did not go for the digesting, waiting for the 4 hours to get the food digested. No such thing is needed. Now it doesn't require to happen. It is a direct experience. So when we are putting the music into our ears, it is getting no need to go down and get it digested in stomach juice. Rather, it goes directly to the brain. It does the difference. So that way, when we are giving music as a therapy, even one more thing I want to mention it here. One, when we are eating food, after the 18th minute only, we feel the stomach is full. After then only you can stop eating food. But there are people, we can have some limited food. There are some, we can go for, what exactly you can say? That is simple food, I mean, that's 4 or 5 cups. That does the difference. So after eating that, when after the 18th minute, we can feel that our stomach is sumptuous, which is going on. That way, when we are giving music, rather, you listen it for 10 to 12 minutes. I give certain music to you. That way, it gives a direct experience. After that, when we are eating food, it takes minimum 3.5 hours, at least 90 minutes or 120 minutes to get it digested and feel the energy. But whereas in music, it is not so. We can do it directly when we are listening the music. So what is music therapy? It is a therapeutic form of presenting. In the modern medicine, in toto, it is modern and medicine is in toto. It is the simple way of giving medications in smaller amount, 2 milligram, 5 milligram, or 25 milligram, at the rarest rare of 500 milligram. Very rarely you give for 1 gram. Very rarely we prescribe for 1 gram. That way, music therapy is a systematic presentation of refined music, refined sound. And mellifluous music to support the individual and encourage the physical, mental, social, and emotional well-being of the individual. The instrumental music plays a very vital role, because when we are singing, the volume may not good, the voice may not good, sometimes it gives subjective feeling. There are people who doesn't understand the words. So that way, instrumental music does the difference, because when you are playing in violin, you give some instrumental, you can touch the end of the note. From end this note to the other note, we need not give any break and carry on playing continuously. But whereas when we are singing, that is not possible for the vocal cord, because our human vocal cord has certain limitations. Very rarely, my guru, he can only continue to give, but that is not possible for everybody. It is not everybody's cup of tea. So the acoustic effect of the saptaswaras has direct effect on the individual, on the internal organs of the body. So that way, music as a therapeutic form, does individuals take the music into their life. One more thing, when we are speaking about the music as a therapeutic medium, in the cognitive, that is corporate medical field, there are two industries. One is sick industry, the other is in health industry. You and I fell sick and go for the treatment. That is called sick industry. That is everywhere throughout the globe, that is the practice is being taken into. But where there are people who doesn't want to get into the sickness arena at all, they want to be in good health all the 365 days of the year. So that way, when those in that area also, music as a therapeutic medium gives the importance. Music, the sick industry, it is comes under nephrology, then the skin areas, cardiology, then there are so many areas. It goes for the pain, then surgical theater, open surgery theater, music can be given for the patients as well as to the doctors also. Then in compared to health industries, human, that is in child health care also, we can give music therapy. Then in women care also, that is gynecology and obstetric also, we can give music therapy. Then in obstetric, that is in pregnancy, it is not comes under sickness. It is neither sickness nor health. It is a development of womanhood. A lady gets married, getting into the motherhood, is a development of womanhood. So that way, there also the music therapy does the difference. It does wonders. We can claim that way. So that way, when we are started giving, that is sick industry and the health industry. Sick industry, for the cardiology section, you can give music therapy. There, the music, it gives the, makes the cell little bit function to its level. When we are giving music for the diabetes, it is the, there are two things available. One, diabetes, it is comes under DNA. The particular individual derives it from his parents. So there are individuals, they develop diabetes because of the work stress, because they doesn't know how to come out of the stress. They do not know how to de-link themselves from the stressful job or stressful work schedules or stressful household chores, whatever it is. So stress, you should learn to de-link ourselves every day at the end of the work schedules, de-link from the stress. That way it does the difference. There are too many andaragangas that makes an individual to come out of the stress more easily. Because when you started mentioning about the name of the raga, yet this particular andaragandharam may available in a humpty number of names. In classical music, our Indian classical music is the world's basic. From there, you can have Western classical, all the Western classical music. Even Hindustani classical is having very few spoon of music from us. So Indian classical music, it is having around 5,55,000 ragas with us. There are many ragas we can able to listen in the same way. But there are people who doesn't know the number of name of the ragas also. But without, one more thing, if you want to become a music therapist, you should be well-versed in music. You cannot purchase music from the counter and play it to the patients. The patient may likely to require a better thing. At that time, you can modify the music and give it added one more notes that you can get it in there. That way, that will be a immediate mixing of medication, doesn't have any expiry date. Immediately given as a fresh as tender coconut. It's fresh. It can be given directly. So this way, this type of music, that is the pure classical music with instrumentals, there is no subjective voice feeling should be there. So that can be given to the patient. In the music therapy session also, you can have two varieties. One is active form of music therapy. The other one is passive form of music therapy. When you are listening, that's what you did a few minutes before. When I'm singing, when I'm giving, presenting the music, or the audience are listening it. That is comes at a passive form of listening. The active form of listening, that is active form of listening, that is active form of participation in music therapy sessions, useful for the neurological patients. Those who are able to be active but unable to speak. for them to elicit their behavior to come out and speak, to verbalize them. That for them, if you give words, figures, words, there are certain words they're likely to stimulate, they're likely to erupt their feelings. For them, the active form of music therapy will be useful. With regard to passive form of music therapy, it does wonder in the medical field. Does wonder. In, for example, I shall give one idea, one simple example. In the obstetric area, that is pregnancy, the woman development of womanhood, there the music given to the pregnant ladies. Everywhere it is being proved. The womb, the fetus in the mother's womb listens music from outside. But what exactly I have proved? By 133rd day of pregnancy, you say by fifth month start, at the end of the 19th week, if you started giving music, the fetus listens to music. For example, now it is 11:30 in the afternoon, forenoon. So we give music now. It is 11:31 now. Then after that, 4 hours later, give on 15 minutes of music. Then after that, tomorrow around 11:30, same time, tomorrow morning, give music. For example, you started giving this music of 20 minutes per session, 4 or 5 days, at the most 10th day, the fetus sticks to the timings. The fetus sticks to the timings. If the mother forgets, but she is having another household chore that time, the fetus reminds the mother by giving extra cake. To her surprise, if she sees her watch, it is 11:30 morning. The fetus sticks to the timing. You give that music, the fetus listens. That this music can be taken till the day of delivery, even to the delivery room. So it goes on. So I am giving this music, you make the music to listen the mother. There is nothing required for the fetus. Whatever the mother does, everything can be observed, can be passed on to the fetus in the mother's womb. Whatever she does, even she gets annoyed, even she gets frightened, she overhearing some angry or emotionally disturbed conversation, those things can be passed on to the fetus. That's why we used to protect the mothers to be, because don't go for the chandai, don't go for the other calls. There is some nasty sound is going on. Please seclude yourself. Do not venture into that. That way, we will protect the pregnant ladies. Because it is the reason. It is the protection for the ladies as well as to be born in. We'll have to be more careful to the fetus. So that way, we have continued to give the music. It is going on. After 2 weeks, the fetus sticks to the timings. These are all the benefits. Not only this. Because of this, the stress in the pregnancy time does not develop. Thereby, the pregnant ladies doesn't develop any edema. It ensures normal delivery 100%. That can be, it is an assurance. 100% normal delivery. After that, if you listen to this music, this ability to be with the music persists with the baby for 84 months after the delivery. During this period, if you initiate the baby in any one of the asserting activities laid on the related to right hemisphere, number work, planning, cognition, depth perception, designing, computer software programming, drawing, craft, even again music into that, the child learns ahead of the schedule by 4 weeks. You and I can also learn music. There are other children who doesn't have the exposure, that mother doesn't have the exposure to music during their pregnancy. Those children also can learn, but they have to learn a particular phrase. Jaya Jaya Guru Nanga, Jaya Jaya Priya Gayaka Neta. This particular simple phrase, it will take them to listen and grasp and sing again. That for them, it will take minimum 4 weeks. Whereas the children who have the exposure during their pregnancy to listen music, they learn it on the very day. The very same, whenever we started teaching, they listen it and grasp it and sing it again. So that way, this ability to be with the music persists with the baby for 84 months of the delivery. During this period, if you initiate the baby in any one of the activities related to right hemisphere, the child learns ahead of the schedule. Not only cognitive ability, even the physical activities, crawling, raising, crossing the door, and climbing the staircase, all these things can be attained 4 weeks ahead of the schedule. For example, a child's mother, when she was a child, she used to stand holding and walk only by the 11th month. Whereas this particular child will do that in 9 months and 1 day. That means it can be ascertained by asking the grandmother how the mother is dying. So that way it is a proving, that is proof of the pudding is in eating. Na? Likewise, it is an one more ability to be with the music. So this is very simple. It is neither comes under sickness nor comes under healthy. It is the development of womanhood. The child is, we are putting the child into the developmental, that is cognitive ability is very sound. This is one thing. The other one more thing can I share with the audience. This is pregnancy, that is 84 months up to the age of 7 years. The child learns music, child learns all cognitive abilities with grasp. Ability to grasp, the shrewdness will be with the child. With regard to cardiology, there are people who doesn't know how to come out of their stress. The stress related to cardiac problem. Simple thing, diet. Whatever we eat, that has an impact on our behavior. For example, now I'm speaking very fresh. I'm in hunger, I'm in thirst. I'll have to quench my thirst, then only I can speak. Then the volume will be very easier to listen. Otherwise, I'll have to find difficult to express myself. That is, quenching the thirst is basic. Then I'm in hunger. I should quench myself. I should fill my stomach and take the food, go for the lecture. So if it is the energy is level little bit lower, I'll have to put forth extra energy by adding energy to that. That way, the whatever we eat, that acts on our behavior. If it is a simple thing, rather if instead of quenching my thirst, I started taking brewing something other than that, which is offendable while doing a meeting, what it will happen? How my words will be? I started blurring, and it is not clear. So that way, whatever we eat, that comes under behavior. That way, whatever we listen, that comes under expressive. If you started listening, whatever the all colloquial, all special, all easy to express, all acceptable words, if you started speaking, if you guide the child, that way he takes into. For them, if you give a music which is based on certain notes, which I don't want to mention the name of the raga. Why? In the sense, if you started doing it, there are many ragas like that. There may people may likely to misuse it. So that way, if you give certain notes in that, that makes them to make their breathing level, that is oxygen, they are able to breathe very well. Intake of oxygen will be more. They can able to come out of their problem. But there is no need. But I don't want to deny they should come out of their medication immediately. No, not at all that. They may be with the medication, but over the period, the saturation point may likely to erupt. Thereby they went to add more medications, which is not required. Once you started with to maintain a level, that can be maintained till you come out of this problem. This is possible with regard to cardiology. Thereby you can exclude yourself from CABG, exclude yourself from angiogram, many things that can be easily given to the patients. They can be saved from their hefty packet of expenditure. Then with regard to, I can give that, since it is very much useful in the pediatric areas, pediatrics is too many, it is a ocean. You can give many things. There are normal children, the so-called normal children, the so-called behavior problematic children. There are problematic behavior instead of they having behavior as their problem, because doesn't know how to express themselves. Doesn't know, because there are children, if they have, because of the mother's carelessness during their pregnancy, that leads to the autistic behavior in their offspring. Autism is those children doesn't have the mirror learning in their brain that has been given, they will take it, but they cannot learn by anything. By learning by seeing will not be there. If you started giving something, those things we can give it to them, whatever the actions they want to do, that can be given by words. Comb your hair, brush your teeth. The brush your teeth is a simple word, a phrase, but there are many more intricacies in between. Sorry. Take the brush, add the paste, put it in your mouth, brush it, put it left to right, all the simple instructions, if it is being given to them, they can learn. That too, if you're given in a tuned format, that will be more easier for them to grasp. That will learn, that will is that will be with them for, since they have learned it once. These are all the betterments. That way, if you give these words into them, they can go for the learning. Therefore, they can go for the acquire the learning is one thing is there. Just to learn household chores or day-to-day routine, that is something different. You should acquire certain things, and for them also the memorizing, to give them all the, if you are a Tamilian, you can give all the attitude from that. If you are, that can be given in their mother tongue. Why I am giving it in the mother tongue, in the sense, it is the easiest form to learn first. If it is not so, we cannot comprehend and fluently communicate in the other's language. It is more applicable for the individual to learn faster in their mother tongue, and they can express it after the mastery of the other languages. That is possible. That's why it is mother tongue, na. It is not father tongue. It is mother tongue. In the throughout the globe, German language is only the father tongue. All other languages in the globe is being considered only as a mother tongue. Whatever the mother speaks, that is your language. Whatever the motherland speaks, that is your language. But whereas in our Bharat, it is something different. We have umpty number of languages. Even in my name, there is one language. But doesn't have it is the phonetic. It can be written, I believe. No idea. That way, in our motherland, we have umpty number of languages. So that way, whatever we want to teach to the autistic children, whatever we want to give the hyperactive children, that can be given in their mother tongue. That is more easier to observe, more easier to grasp. With regard to, there are one more childhood problem. It is stuttering. Yet stuttering may occur because of the emotional disturbance. The child may be punished unwantedly. The child may be punished without any apparent reason, or child may be frightened at some other place, which is the child might have went without informing their parents. Whatever may be the reason, but the child, if he or she is stuttering, there we can give certain music lessons. That is, in the basic classical music lessons, there are certain two letter syllables, ga ga ri ri sa sa, ga 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 pa pa ri ga ga sa ri ri ni sa sa, pa ga ri ni sa, pa ga ri ni sa, like that, all these twisted notes we started teaching the child. And after that, just for few minutes, you say 6 or 7 minutes, after 7 minutes you give a text of their mother tongue, make them to read. You come read it in few minutes. You say the same 7 minutes. It is the child slowly pronounces the word and started reading it as little, because he is having the stuttering. One more thing, we cognitive neurologists, we don't say that they are stuttering. They are lesser in their speech fluency. Fluency is a little bit lesser. We don't want to brand the child that she or he is having stuttering. Rather, we make the child, his fluency is limited, na. So you can increase your fluency by reading it aloud. For the same procedure, same paragraph is being given on day 3. The first day, the child has taken minimum 7 minutes to read out the 200 words of comprising a paragraph. The same 200 words on the day 3, or that is on the third session of the music therapy, the child reads out in 2 minutes. Very fantastic helping mode of the music listening, singing with OCAN. There is no listening, only tunes. It is only listening by words, repeating it. This is some way it can be considered as the active form of music therapy. This can be given, that the speech fluency over the period increases. For example, there is two constables. They want to enroll themselves into the police force of Tamil Nadu police force. They came for the treatment to me, madam, this is what I am experiencing. I am unable to speak fluently. If I don't speak fluently, I cannot be selected for this job. Will you help me? Then I asked them 6 weeks time. In that 6 weeks time, less than that, half of it, you say, on the third week completion itself, all the two constables, they can able to improve their fluency. They can able to read very well, read aloud. There is no shy in there. There is no stuttering. That is, the words are doesn't get stuck in between. So they continue to speak fluently, because less than that, it is individual tailor-made. You cannot generalize. It is not, it cannot be given everybody. Those who are having this type of problem, then they can be given this type of music and individualize. That is like treatment. You cannot give paracetamol for all the audience in this meeting, because they doesn't have any pain. Paracetamol means for certain people, but it is not required for everyone. There are people, if you ask them to keep quiet, enjoy the breathe, go for the fresh diet, that helps a lot. That helps a lot. That way, how many minutes I am having in remaining? Anyone can guide me? Hello? Hello? So that way, it is taking somewhat individual requirements to approach music as a therapy. So music, it can be given in Ayurveda, that is, go for the, while having the treatment also, music can be given. Then Ayurveda, it speaks about all the three doshas. If you have whatever, it depends on the food, makes a difference. If you take more spicy, you will become rajas. The rajas will be dominated. If you take more kadvalamsa, lavana dvamsha, if you are more spicy or salty or 3 days back prepared food, it makes you to more lazy, tamasam. If you take sattvarajasa, the fresh prepared food without much spice and salt, it will make you hold on to the more sattva. The sattva, if sattva guna is dominating, rajas and tamas is putting under control, you can do many things alert and actively, more refreshingly. If sometimes one it dominates the other, if tamasa is dominating, then we will be a bit more sluggish. If the rajas are a bit more sluggish, we will be more emotional, ready to use harsh words. It may hurt others by our activities also. That way, whatever we want to do, whatever we want to make things accordingly, our food habits should also be there. When we are giving music, the music should be in the end to end, is easily playable. It should be listened. It should be listened. While the passive form of music should be listened, active form of music should be participated. These things can be given into that. In that way, music as a therapeutic form, for example, the time of what, how we are taking food, in that limited time, it takes into the digestion area. Like that, if you listen music for this number of minutes, that does the saturation point. That is, in brain, there is one place is there, amygdala. When we are sitting here, some corporation lorry is going, when we are driving in the road, what will happen? Immediately we will hold our nostril. What is that? The strongest stimuli affects the amygdala. It may be, I'm giving a negative information, negative example, because corporation kuppalari. But whereas when we are listening very superfluous, mellifluous music, that also stimulates the amygdala. Thereby it stores into the brain. It makes you more active. That is why you listen music. The stimuli won't be superior in quality, without disturbing our personal whims and fancies, without creating any subjective negative feelings, all positives, all acceptable behavior in the mindset, with the listening, does the wonder for the patients as well as the normal. I am concluding my session. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Maithili.
Okay.
Welcome our next speaker, Isai Kalar Valarmani, Sri R. Ganesh Raman. pursuing PhD research in Madurai Kamaraj University, Madurai. Currently, he's working as a lecturer in Tamil Nadu Government Music College, Coimbatore. Sri Ganesh Raman, a performing artist, Carnatic vocalist, was initially trained by Srimati Banumati Sethuraman and later on took advanced classes under the tutelage of Chertala Dr. K. N. Ranganath Sharma of Chennai. Sri Ganesh Raman was conferred with the title Isai Kalar Valarmani by the Department of Art and Culture, Government of Tamil Nadu. Let's welcome Sri Ganesh Raman.
Namaskar, madam. Madam, my voice is now audible for all?
Yes, audible. Yes.
Namaskar to all. My name is Ganesh Naman from Trishtarpalli. I'm a sincere heartfelt thanks to Sri Dhanmantri Kalakshetra Sheila Madam for conducting an online webinar in Raga as diet and its therapeutic benefits. Now I will explain the term music therapy and how the Carnatic Ragas and as well as related to Hindustani Raga can cure therapeutic effects in both, applied in both vocal and as well as instrument.
Mr. Ganesh, some disturbance in the voice.
But now, madam, now.
Yeah, still better. Okay.
Raga, it is defined as Raga plus Ga, that is in Sanskrit term. Now, in 7th century, in Matanga, in Lakshana Grandam, in according to musical term Lakshana Grandam, in Brigadesi, the term the Raga was first mentioned by Matanga. Now, I am now I give some explanation about the Raga and Carnatic Ragas and as well as related to Hindustani Ragas to cure some of the diseases in the music therapy. Now let us take the first Raga. It is the raga name is Amrita Varshini. The Amrita Varshini ragam is hailed from the name of rain from throughout the all the world. The Amrita Varshini ragam. Now I will sing the ragam structure. This ragam can cure the heat or stroke or heat something related diseases. Now let us have some Hindustani related raga. The raga name is Ahir Bhairo. Ahir Bhairo ragam is a well-known composition is Sadasiva Brahmendra. It's a well-known of Bibare Ramarasam. Bibare Ramarasam Rasane Bibare
ramarasam bibare ramarasam rasane in Carnatic music raga some of the raga the well known raga it is Anand Bhairavi this Anand Bhairavi raga is can cure the mainly stomach problems and kidney related to problems it reduces the health point every ragam has a unique nature and the ragam presently for only jeeva swaram in the practical oriented as well as playing in any other instrument like veena or violin or some other instruments now on the bari compositions in ragam Anand Bhairavi a well known composition of Navavarnam of Dikshitar kamala ambaga sam rakshatu man every ragam is raksha only the jeeva swaram of this any out of this Carnatic ragas the well known raga of well known raga has indolam it reduces a blood purification in the body and now audible madam some of the network issue madam my voice is audible now
so your voice is audible but there's some disturbances I think can you just unplug your headset and directly I mean
okay.
speak to the device
okay sure now sir
now also slight disturbance is there but
now sir
how is the network there sir is it okay internet speed
but I am also having some disturbance
yeah the voice is garbling so that's why I asked
I will make a headphone sir it is more comfortable for me
please. Okay sir then use it please
the well known ragam of indolam the ragam can reduces the blood purification in the body a well known ragam and a well known kriti I'm going to present now sa ni da ma ga ma ga sa ramanukku mannoodi tharithale nanmai unduru kale mannoodi tharithale nanmai unduru kale மன்னன் மூடி தரித்தாலே. And again, and the another ragam is now a Melakartha in musical Carnatic music. The 72 Melakartha is the in the 72 Melakartha, the third Melakartha. The third Melakartha is Ganamurthi. It is Anna, which completely reduces the diabetic diseases like high blood pressure and low blood pressure. In a Ganamurthi, one of the prolific composer and Saint Thyagaraja Swamigal, among the musical trinities, Saint Thyagaraja Swamigal composed a kriti in Ganamurthi Melakartha. Dharugunam itself creates Dhanisa Sanigab Maga Magare. The Gandharam is Shuddha Gandharam. The Shuddha Gandharam can be sung in the Sadushila Rishabham place. When we sing the Shuddha Gandharam or any other Vivadi Swaram, we should not shake. But we should not shake. If we shake, means the raga cannot add a beauty to this kriti. And when we sing, but in music therapy, the Ganamurthi, this Melakartha, reduces the diabetic problems or diabetic diseases related to some high blood pressure and low blood pressure something. I will sing the Ganamurthi. Ganamurthi. The starting itself. The Shuddha Gandharam, the Gandharam in the musical term, it adds a very pleasant and modifying beauty to this Melakartha. If we sing the Anupalavi in the Mani Ni Mani Sri Rupini Mani Ni Mani Sri Rupini, the word, the Sagityam Sri Daga Garisam Daga Garisam Sanida Danida Puma Pumaga. The Gandharam is adds a beauty to this Melakartha. It is very pleasant to hear and pleasant to present a song or pleasant to play in any other instrument. But most of the Carnatic ragas and one more, the Hindustani related raga is this Pilu. The pilu is related to Carnatic some kapi raga. That Pilu ragam can be sung only in Madhyama Shuddhi, in musical term. A well-known composition in Sadashiva Brahmendra, a prolific composer. Bajare yadunatham manas bajare yadunatham manas bajare. And that word itself, then swaram itself, sasaram in Madhyama Shruti. So it has a very beautiful in Pilu in Hindustani related ragam. Then due to pandemic situation in this COVID-19, that allergic of asthma and bronchitis problem, itself problem can be cured by two ragams. It is very well known and major ragam, and as well as one Velakirtha ragam also added in this bronchitis and asthma related problems. That major ragam is well known of Thodi. So Thodi is the it is very difficult ragam, because that the swara prayogas, the swara prayogas and a way of presenting itself very difficult, but through listening or through able to sing, it can cure asthma bronchitis problems and breathing problems. If we sing a Thodi, the Gandharam, Daivadam, Vishadam, it's a very very important jeevaswaram. Important jeevaswaram in this Thodi ragam. So Thodi ragam is the major ragam, and it is difficult to present. But when we are listening, or when we are able to sing, or when we are singing, it will definitely cure the breathing problems, the asthma, the bronchitis, some other related. Now I will sing the present the Thodi ragam, and what are the important phrases? Ga ma da ni da ni ga ma ga ni ni sa pa ma ga ga da ni da. In this swaram, when we sing in raga alabana according to Carnatic music, the syllables of tadarina tadana in ragam aspect in raga alabana, that Kaisi Nishadam in musical term, that's a very powerful in through breath control. If we sing, when we are landing in Sarjam, that phrase, the Gandharam itself as well, then breath control or any other asthmatic problem, when they are listening in vocal and as well as instrument, it will definitely cure the asthma of allergy, asthma, or any bronchitis, especially the breathing problems. So now it's related to this Thodi ragam. In Melakartha, 72 Melakartha is always a Vakula Barnam. The Vakula Barnam is a Melakartha. A well-known of Maya Mala Goda Melakartha is common to well-known all the music rasikas. In 15th Melakartha, the Maya Mala Goda, after, before that Melakartha, it is Vakula Barnam. It is also Vakula Barnam, it is the Melakartha. Nishadam itself, a very jeevan and prolific in the essential of swara prayogangal in this Melakartha. It is the Melakartha also composed by prolific composer of Saint Tyagaraja Swami. Now I will sing this, present the raga swaras as the time constraint now. Pa pa da ni da da pa ma ga ma pa da pa ma ga re sarigama padani, that nishadam. If we change the padani, that becomes the maya melody. Now padani dani sari madari sani dapama gama padani dapama magama padapama gare maga magare sani that nishadam. Sani itself, it also can cure the asthma or bronchitis problems. If we able to sing or this, or we are listening, through listening only, the ragas can cure the all the type of diseases. So in my conclusion, of a raga has a dietic and therapeutic effects. A ragam, Carnatic ragas and as well as Hindustani related ragas can definitely cure the diseases in presented being vocal and as well as instrument to coming up for future generations to become the awareness of music therapy and ragas to live a very healthy life. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you. Thank you, Sri Ganesh Raman.
Thank you. Thank you.
Our last speaker for today, Guru Srimati Priya Iyer, disciple of late Sri Ranganathan Bhagavatar of Kolkata. She is a corporate trainer, a music teacher, and a Bhagavad Gita preacher. She will share her thoughts with us today as how she would advise her students. Welcome, Priya ma'am.
Thank you very much. Namaskar, Hare Krishna. So first of all, thank you for this opportunity. I am humbled because the rest of the speakers were all highly qualified with a lot of details, a lot of knowledge. So I shall share what I have learned along the way, more than technical qualifications per se. For a fairly long period in my career, I worked as the head of the call center in one of the banks in Sydney, Australia. And there, I was handling the complaints section for a very long time. You must be wondering, why am I telling you about my career now? But I learned one valuable thing when I was working there, and that was this. For customers, it was not just what we said that mattered. It was how we put it across to them that mattered to them. So more than communicating details, the connect became very important. So one of my lines to my students or the team used to be, it is not just your words, but it is the music that makes your words count. Because words tell us the matter of fact, it is the music that brings the emotional connect, which actually help us deal with situations. A lot of times, if things were said correctly, said nicely in the way they were intended to be, the complaint never eventuated into actually becoming a complaint. Right from when I was learning music, from my childhood, I started learning at the age of 7. Two things intrigued me. One, what do all these things mean? Because most of the songs that I learned in my Carnatic music learning career, at least the ones that my Guru Sri, late Sri Ranganatha Bhagavatar taught me, were either in Telugu, or they were Shama Shastri Kritis, or they were Sanskrit compositions of Muthuswami Dikshitar, some Papanashim Shivan Kritis also. So one thing that I always wanted to know is what they meant, all these compositions, and why certain ragas have been chosen. What is the prayojana of all these sangatis, which we sing the same line in so many different ways? I often wondered, what is the connection between all of this? And during my learning journey, when I started to focus on that more and more, as I began to think about that more and more, I realized that all these three things are intertwined. Earlier, we heard Dr. Aishat speak, and even Dr. Maithili speak about the gunas and how the various gunas play within us, and it's the supremacy of different gunas why we behave a certain way at a certain time. And this is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita as well. Lord Krishna has spent a lot of time discussing about the three gunas, the sattva guna, rajoguna, and the tamoguna. So I have often tried to think about what these songs meant. So just to give you some examples of various compositions, various things, you know, as to how these ragas must have been chosen. Another thing I have often wondered is this. In my family, there are a lot of established singers. And I was one time having this casual conversation with Dr. N. Rajam, the violinist, or the violinist, if you like. She's one of the doyens, you know. I was having a conversation with her. When I sit through a music class and I have to teach music over three hours, for example, I change positions at least a dozen times. How is it possible that these great Carnatic musicians or Hindustani musicians can sit through a concert for 3 hours as though they were in some kind of trance, as though they were in some kind of meditation for 3 hours in the same position? And they are usually not seated in a comfortable sofa or a chair or anything, back erect with no back support. You know, they're not eating or drinking except a little bit of water or perhaps some warm milk. How is it possible that they are doing that? And that also answered the same thing. It must be, the magic must be happening because of the ragas that they are singing and the therapeutic effects that they have. Each raga, and we have thousands of them, like Dr. Maitri was mentioning, each raga has got a capacity to take care of certain faculties in our body. And these great musicians, these stalwarts, if you like, they must be singing each of these ragas with precision. And therefore, when they were singing all these ragas, all these sound vibrations, all the ragas must be catering to the different needs of their body. And that must be keeping each faculty, each cell. Each cell has got sound vibrations. We heard that earlier today. It must be keeping them intact the way it should be. Their habits are very sattvic. Their singing mood is sattvic. We'll come to mood shortly. So therefore, that also reinforced my firm belief that there is a firm connect between what we are singing, what we are saying, and how we are presenting it, the sound, for example. So if we were to look at various different ragas, you know, I will demonstrate very few, you know, because we're running out of time with whatever time we have, you know. So if we look at a raga, for example, Sahana. Sahana Ragam has got the capacity to calm our minds. It has got the power to cure us of depression. It has got this immediate capacity to almost calm us down. The Ragam is such. And if we look at the meaning of what the song meant, there is a composition of Swati Tirunari. See, one beautiful thing about our Indian classical music is they are not just random words. These songs were written by great personalities who were great Bhagavatas and devotees of the Supreme Lord. Therefore, each song that they wrote and they composed was basically them building their rapport with their Supreme Lord. Each of the words they said had a connect with the Supreme Divinity, and they selected ragas accordingly to convey their emotion as best as they could. So in this composition of Swati Tirunal says, the beauty of the Lord is such that if you take the name of the Lord, that is enough to cleanse us of all the tamasic, all the unnecessary rajasic swabhavas or thoughts that we may have in our body. And Swati Tirunal has chosen Ragam Sahana for this purpose. So let us look at the line which specifically says this. Nayana Jita Kamala Rama Durita Mala Nama Durita Mala Nayana Jita Kamala Nama He's explaining here the purpose of the Nama, the power in the Nama of the Supreme Lord, which has the capacity to cleanse us of any durita mala, means dirt. Likewise, Tyagarajan, you know, after all, these great people wrote these songs because they wanted to attain the Supreme. And what I'm trying to emphasize here is the ragam they chose facilitated in their connecting with the divine. Tyagaraja Swamigal has written this great composition in the ragam Saramati called Mokshamu Galada. And he's seeking moksha in the Pallavi of the song. And in the Anupallavi, he's mentioning about the importance of Sangeetam with Sadbhakti. So he says knowledge of music is important. Like Dr. Maithili was saying, music cannot be purchased from a store. Jnanam cannot be purchased from a store. It is a gift. It is a blessing that we receive from the divine. So therefore, it's absolutely essential that we offer it back to the divine. Like it says, you know, in the Gitam lessons when we learn. You know, I have wondered what these Gitams meant, and that answered my question. Purandaradasar has written. It is as though offering the water back into the lake. So the water has been given to me. I'm taking the water from the lake and I'm offering it back unto the lake. So I'm receiving this music from Samaveda, from the divine, and offering it back to the divine with my bhava, with my emotion. So Tyagaraja says, if I want to meet the Supreme Lord, I need to know Sangeetam. What kind of Sangeetam? What kind of Sangeeta Jnana? Sangeeta Jnana, which has got Sadbhakti in it. So how does he say it? Let us look at it in the Ragam Saramati. Just by singing this one line itself, I feel as though for that brief moment, I am in touch. I am in touch with the Divine Supreme. Sangeeta jnana vihinulaku. What? Sangeeta jnana vihinulaku mokshamu galada. Mokshamu galada. Bhuvilo jivan muktulu gani varagu mokshamu galada. So here we can see how the ragam Saramati is helping us to, it is almost like Tyagaraja is pleading. So when we are singing these kind of ragams, invariably it will do to us that, if I just say, Sakshat Karuni Sangeeta Jnana Vihinulaku Moksha Mugalada, it is probably going to have the same meaning. But what the music has done, hello? Sorry, I thought someone wanted to say something. what the ragam has done, it has actually added value to those words. It has actually helped us connect better, isn't it? So yes, the ragam itself is definitely going to be of use. We learned about several ragams in our earlier speeches when our esteemed speakers spoke. Yes, it is like if you take a paracetamol, it is going to cure us of a pain, or the symptoms of the pain will certainly go, whether I take the paracetamol knowing all the ingredients in them or without knowing, it's still going to work. But knowing about it improves my receptivity, improves my ability to connect, or connectivity, isn't it? The purpose of communication ultimately is to connect with the person that I'm speaking to. So all these various ragas, Ananda Bhairavi, aha, what a beautiful ragam Ananda Bhairavi is. Yes, it has got all the therapeutic effects about reducing blood pressure, stomach ailments and everything. You know, this great composition in this, the composer is saying to Mother Goddess, won't you talk to me? And he's pleading. And he's chosen Ananda Bhairavi as a ragam. We heard Kamalamba earlier. Sri Ganesh Ji was speaking about Kamalamba, Navavarna Kriti. In this particular Kriti, the composer is saying, Himachala Tanaya Brochudakiti Manchi Samaya Mura. Himachala Tanaya, isn't it time for you to talk to me yet? Brochudakiti Manchi Samaya Mura. And what is he asking her? Vega me hima chale tanaya bro chude kiti manchi samaya mura vega me hima chale tanaya. Don't the lines automatically sound as though we are pleading Mother Goddess to listen to us? I'll give you another example of how these sangatis progressively speak. The raga speaks, even though it is the same line that is being spoken. There's a composition of Tyagaraja in which he is asking Lord Rama, Enta vedu kondu raghava, pantamelara? Pantamelara is a question. Why are you stubborn? Won't you listen to me? Now, there are different ways we ask a question, don't we? When we have to say something the first time, we say it a certain way. Second time, we say it in a certain way. Third time, it gets progressively more assertive. Let's look at how the sangatis are doing the job. This is where we get to begin to understand why these composers have chosen certain ragams, so that the emotion can be conveyed effectively. So let us look at this ragam. It's called Saraswati Manohari. Yanta vedu kundu raghava pantamelara o raghava. So here he's telling Raghava, why are you stubborn? Won't you talk to me? Now look at the next line. Oh, looks like Raghava didn't hear. So he's saying, Yenta vedu kondu raghava pantamelara o raghava. Raghava, aren't you my Raghava? You're still stubborn. Here he's not angry yet. Looks like Raghava is still waiting. He hasn't answered the prayers. Pantamelara. Watch the change in mood. Oh, Raghava. He's pleading in desperation. Oh, Raghava. Yenta vedu kondu Raghava. Pantamelara. Oh, Raghava. Yenta vedu kondu. It almost sounds as though Tyagaraja is telling Raghava, come on, I've been calling you for so long. Are you going to answer my prayers or what? Look at how progressively the sanghatis are moving. They move from a nice mood to a request, from a yearning request to almost, you know, when you're very close to somebody, you can almost ask them, are you going to answer my prayers or not? He ends it again. He's like probably thinking, oh, maybe I'm being a little rough with my Raghava. I often, you know, we cannot become those Bhagavatas. We cannot become those divine personalities. We never will. God knows how many janmas it is going to take. However, if we begin to closely watch the ragas that they have assigned to convey various moods, what is raga therapy after all? It is trying to fix various problems in us. It is the problems which cause variations in our moods. When we are diseased, we don't feel good. When we are okay, we feel happy. Disease problems directly proportional to our moods, aren't they? Isn't it? We do all the right things when we are happy. When we are not happy, we know the right things, but we are unable to do it because we've got a diseased body. The body is not at ease. That is why these tunes, these musical notes help us handle all those things. But these are topics that can be spoken forever and forever. I just wanted to say just a little bit today so that it makes us think as to why certain ragas have been chosen, why there are this ragam for this song. They are not random song music, you know, like composers have, you know, these days choose. It's not like this. Very scientific. It's very scientific. It is intentional. It is full of purpose. That is why we should be proud of our classical music, Hindustani, Carnatic, where we not only have great composers who knew what they were saying, they said wonderful things, and they taught us how to say it with the help of these ragas. So thank you for listening to me today. Thank you for giving me this opportunity, Sheila ji, Krishna Kumar ji. And thank you all, audience, for patiently listening in. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Srimati Priya Iyer. Thank you. With this, we conclude our session for today. I hope there are no questions to be asked by anyone. Okay. We would like to thank all our four speakers for your golden words of thoughts, words of enlightenment. Each of you spoke in four different ways, still connecting to raga as diet and its therapeutic values. Dr. Aishat, she's connected raga with Ayurveda treatment, and Dr. Maithili with the fetus and the motherhood, and Mr. Ganesh, raga related with the diseases, and Srimati Priya, the emotions with the ragas, all superbly done, very well expressed. Thanks a lot once again to all our speakers. We would like to thank our managing director, Sri Krishna Kumar ji, for giving us this opportunity to host this program. Thanks to Sir for all the kind gestures shown to us. Our courtesies and thanks to Sri Shivadas Warrior, Director, AVP, for the perfect guidance. Thanks to Parvati ma'am. Thanks to Sri Krishnadas Warrior for all the cooperation and help extended. Our courtesies to Professor Maya of Avinashi Lingam University. Thanks to Mr. Vinod of the Marketing Department. Thanks to Jitesh and Joel of the IT Department. Thank you, viewers, with all your blessings and prayers. This is Sri Dhanvantri Kalakshetra signing off for the day. Thank you.